الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن محمدا بشيرا ونذيرا وعبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد إمام المتقين وسيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى بالقرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعد الظن إثم ولا تجسسوا وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أهان سلطان الله في الأرض أهانه الله صدق رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. The brothers and sisters, with the changing situation and the challenges for the Muslims all over, there is a requirement on our part to be as truthful as possible, as well as not to be insulting to others, though we may get insulted. And that is why I chose the topic of insulting is unethical. We all know that expressing insult during a conversation, either to the person engaged in direct talks or insulting a person in absentia, is unethical. The very first principle of such an insult is that it reciprocates back to us as insulter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam never insulted anyone who engaged in conversation, no matter whatever the person believed, because communication in peaceful manner always keeps the door open for future talks, for future inculcation, and for future consultations. A believer in Islam and mindful of Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not insult the honor of others, nor curse, nor commit vulgarity, nor is he foul. Especially insulting a fellow Muslim who recognizes Allah, who recognizes Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, would never ever insult a Muslim, because it is an act of disobedience to God, and quarreling against him would be considered as disbelief, as an act of kufr, as mentioned in a hadith of sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We are Muslims and call ourselves so because we have taken an oath of allegiance towards Allah and his last messenger Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Such an allegiance is not verbal. It is consensual in our hearts, with convictional belief in our heart, mind and body to say so in totality. Thus, whoever believes in Allah and in the last day should talk what is good and should refrain from talking out of rage and anger. That is the best for a believer. Who believes in Allah and the last day should not insult his neighbor. Whoever believes in Allah the last day should entertain his guest generously, as per the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When two people insult each another, definitely there will be always a person who started the insult. So he will be the main reprimandable person in such a conversation, the one who keeps quiet and makes sabr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses, and he only tells such a person what is the truth, and then hajurhum hajran jameela, and he parts the party in good manner. Let me share a story during the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There was a very well-known Sahabi. Everybody knows the name Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala. Like anybody, he would also have a slave. So one day he insulted the slave as per the word of the Hadith by taking his mother's name. The person was very much annoyed, but being a master and he being a slave, he couldn't say anything. He made the sabr. And he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and explained everything. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept quiet and called upon Abu Dharr. Oh Abu Dharr, did you do so and so? Abu Dharr was quiet. It means he did it. So Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala and without further inquisitivity, he was inculcated or given a suggestion or a guidance. Guidance comes from Allah, but definitely Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam inculcated the guidance. Oh Abu Dharr, your brothers are your property. Allah has put them under your authority. If someone has his brother under his authority, he should feed him from what he eats and clothe him from what he wears and not burden him with anything that will be too much for him. If you burden him with what will be too much for him, then help him. After listening this, Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala an, when he came out, first he did was he changed the clothing of his slave and gave his clothing what he used to wear, and he also wore the same clothing. And the people said, what happened to Abu Dharr? His slave and the master both are dressing in the same manner. Why? Because they were mindful. They were obedient to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the messenger as khuluqin azim. And because of that, the Prophet neither talked in an insulting manner, nor did he ever speak evil intentionally. He used to say to his companions and whomsoever he met, the most beloved to me among you is the one who has the best character and manners. Similarly, there is one more very important incident. One companion, Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, was sitting in the companionship of Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam joined them. A man looking very furious came to Abu Bakr and insulted him. Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu kept quiet. And the Prophet smiled. Then that person insulted Abu Bakr Siddiq second time, and the Prophet kept smiling. The third time, whatever Abu Bakr Siddiq might have thought, he retaliated against the person who was insulting him. And then the smile from the face of the Prophet was gone, and he left the gathering. Realizing that something wrong has happened, Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu left the gathering, and the guy also, no matter what he says, who cares, because he had more care for the Prophet than anything else. He came running, Ya Rasulullah, did I bother you or did I anger you? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Oh Abu Bakr, as long as that person was insulting you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended an angel from the sky. He was speaking and replying him and cursing him on your behalf. The moment you became a party to him in his character, the angel was gone and a devil came next to you, smiling and praising you. So that's why you don't expect the messenger of Allah to sit next to devil. That's why I came out. There is a good example in this. Dear brothers and sisters, It is time to ponder. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah Hujurat, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ فَأَصْلِحُوا بَيْنَ أَخَوَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Certainly believers are members of the same religious order like we are. Thus mend fences between the brothers. So if we have any trouble, we have to support each other to mend the fences. Be mindful of Allah on such matters so that you succeed. O you who believe, let not a congregation scoff at another congregation. We always see in our Muslims congregations, because we have different sects now, groups now, and we all see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us against it. It may be that the latter are better than the former, nor let some women scoff at other women. It may be that the latter are better than the former, nor defame one another, nor insult one another by nicknames. How bad is it to insult one's brother after having faith, calling him a sinner or a wicked person? And whosoever does not repent, and then such are indeed wronging themselves, O believers, do not commit to illicit eloquence. Such may be inflicting you with sin, and do not spy against your brothers. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من أهان سلطان الله في الأرض أهانه الله. Ziyad bin Qusayb al-Adawi, he said, he was sitting with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu in a congregation where the Amir of the region, his name was Ibn Amir, was delivering a khutbah. And he said, Abu Bilal said, look at our Amir wearing clothes of wickedness. So Abu Bakr said, be quiet, I heard the Messenger of Allah saying, whoever insults Allah's Sultan on the earth, Allah disgraces him. Similarly, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam always warned about the respect of his family, the respect about the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he used to say, Allah, Allah fi ashabi, Allah, Allah fi ashabi, la yattakhidhuhum gharadan ba'di faman ahabbahum wa yahubbi ahabbahum wa man abghadahum fa yabughdi abghadahum wa man adhahum faqad adhani wa man adhani faqad adallah wa man adallaha fayushiku an yakhudhahu. What it means? It means mindful of Allah. Fear Allah regarding my companions. Do not make them objects of insults after me when the Prophet is no more. Whoever loves them, it is out of love of me that he loves them. And whoever hates them, it is out of hatred for me that he hates them. And whoever harms them, he has harmed me. And whoever harms me, he has offended Allah. And whoever offends Allah, he shall soon be punished. Rawa Jame Tirmidhi. Dear brothers and sisters, with these few wordings in here, it is time we realize that in this country, where in the name of M103 or in the name of performing Salat in the school, lot of insults are being hurled against the Muslims. There is no tafriq. There is no tafriq. Anybody having a Muslim name is a Muslim. Alhamdulillah. How we should behave under these situations? The first 13 years of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the best example, because we are existing to take the message of the Prophet to these people. Remember what happened around Kaaba during those 13 years? Remember what happened to Sayyidina Umar bin Khattab when he declared Islam around Kaaba? A very powerful man was beaten. Remember what happened in Taif, and many, many examples. So we have to be resilient. We should not insult anyone, but we should be steadfast in our truthfulness. When we need to pray, we need to pray. If the permission is granted, we will pray. If the permission is not granted, we'll just keep on struggling, we'll find other ways. But as long as Charter of Human Rights permits us to look for it, we will keep looking, no matter how the opponents get outraged out of it. We are friendly people, peaceful people, we love. I always say, in the social media, I don't have any border. I hug everybody. Why I hug everybody? To create a softness in the heart, to remove the animosity, to remove the fear. Because when we talk about Dawah, like some extremists say, kafir, he should not come in. No, we don't say that. Nobody is kafir as long as he is not declaring kafir by his action, by his attitude. And the Quran is the witness. Whoever revolted against the Prophet's invitation and took arms against the Prophet, he was declared as kafir. Otherwise, Ya Yuhannas, Ya Yuhannas, wa'budu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum walladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Ya ayyuhan nas, what happened to you? Ma gharraka bi rabbikal kareem, what happened to you? Why you are deviated from your honorable Lord the God? Lam yakun alladhina kafaru min ahli alkitab wal mushrikeen, men, not all, men, those who revolted and refused. We haven't done our job yet. We have not invited yes to majority of the people. So how we can say that who is what? And we don't say anyway, the Prophet did not say anyone until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to say so. وَقُلِ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي مِنْ كُلِّ ذَنْبٍ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ.